Welcome to today's edition of DKTV. We're back at Castle Park for a very important day in the DRFC club history as we celebrate 25 years of club president Tony DeMulder's reign in the position. The occasion, we are welcoming Moseley FC for another round of championship action. Fingers crossed for a good result.
Shine on, harvest moon, up in the sky.
Celebratory 25th anniversary game, and our club president is going to lead the night side out ahead of kickoff against Moseley. So Harry, obviously you've been a long-time supporter of Yorkshire Sports, and we're delighted to have you here at Castle Park for today for Tony's quarter-century celebration as president. What have you made of the first half today?
Well, I suppose not a brilliant match, was it? Certainly the half-time scoreline isn't very good. But I have to say, I feel a bit ashamed because I have never been here before, and I had no idea what a fantastic place it was. I mean, it's astonishing. And I thought, I have to say, that the affection showed to Tony in that lunch today was something to behold. He's a real hero of sport here at Doncaster Knights, and it's a tribute to him that so many people turned up and showed their affection for him. I was quite touched by it.
So even if the fare on the field hasn't been so good yet, fingers crossed for a better second half, but you've enjoyed your time at Castle Park so far anyway.
Loved it. Absolutely loved it. I like my rugby union very much. As I say, they're losing by a point, but that's nothing, is it? They first time that Moseley have attacked, they've scored. That's the way rugby goes sometimes. I fancy that Knights will turn it on in the second half, but it's been a privilege to be here. I've enjoyed it. I've had some great hospitality, and to be part of a special day for Tony, capped it really for me.
Fantastic. I hope you enjoy the rest of the game, and fingers crossed for the second half.
A singer in a smoky room, the smell of wine and cheap perfume. For a smile they can share the night. It goes on and on.
A tricky game, certainly for the first half, but the second half you showed your quality and came good. Another bonus point winning adverse weather conditions here at Castle Park.
Yeah, definitely a game of two halves for us. I mean, we had to grind it out a little bit in the first half and see where we're at, reassess the situation. We always knew we could come out second half and really turn it up a bit, so yeah.
Well, well done. Obviously, we talked about how the Cup games are leading back into the Championship and trying to continue that momentum. And I guess this win sets you up very nicely for a trip to Bedford next Saturday.
Yeah, massive game for us. I mean, it's the last of the first round of competition. And it's one that we've got to win, really. We're going with everything. So,
still very early days, but given Yorkshire's loss last night and the win today, that means that you should be in second place at the round close of the day's games. That must be a good feeling.
Yeah, it's great. It's great. We knew it coming in, obviously, with Yorkshire playing last night. So it was a big incentive for us, really. And yeah, we managed to pull it off. We played well.
Well, congratulations, Paul, for the second week running. You're today's man of the match. We're going to pop over to the other side to do the presentation.
Cheers, mate.